KSBW Weather with Jim Vanderzwan.
Another fine day to close out the week. Nice temperatures, 81 in San Jose, Watsonville, 72. It's going to set the stage for some good flying weather for the weekend. Monterey, fair is going, 73 degrees right there. Salinas, 77, 82 in King City. Lovely day. Little patchy fog for the rest. A few thunderstorms coming up this year in Nevada. Most of it on the other side of the ridge there. Always keeping an eye out for lightning. And we may see a little more tropical moisture later in the weekend. More on that in a minute. 90s, though. Told you today would be the hottest day. Boy, we got that right. Look at that. Mid to upper 90s in the Santa Cruz Mountains. 90 in Santa Cruz, said Ron. Didn't last long, but it was there in the book, and it was a warm day all day long. 67 in Pacific Grove, that's your cool spot. 70 in Seaside Monterey, 71 in Marina, 74 Carmel, 92 in Carmel Valley and Big Sur. Bested that by a couple of degrees. You got into the nines from Soledad South, and then 82 for Salinas, 86 in Gonzales. And Santa Clara Valley, as you might guess, was warm. 88 in San Jose, but 10 warmer than that in Morgan Hill and Gilroy, and 95 in Hollister. So, yep, little shot of summer for you there. Almost as hot as the Central Valley. Did get to 100 in Fresno. We got close in a few spots, 97 Sacramento, Bakersfield, and Palm Springs. A little bit of cloudiness there, keeping them a little cooler. Pretty warm on the beaches in the Southland, too. Got a little hint of an offshore flow for a while there. 79 in Seattle, got 90 in Denver, Boise, nice and dry, 101 in Phoenix, nice and dry, 100 in Dallas, not so dry. It's pretty hot, it's sticky, 102 in St. Louis. There's a little bit of humidity involved. Not as much as typically could be the case, because normally you wait for what they call the Gulf to open up and really bring that humid air up. It's kind of on the drier side now, but some of it's coming along the front range of the Rockies. That's firing off some pretty good thunderstorms. Watch these babies come up out of nowhere. Boom, there they are, topping at about 60,000 feet. Some other good ones dropping into the Ohio Valley. Last night they had severe weather over parts of Minnesota and Wisconsin. That dropped off, and all of a sudden, watch this come up again here. Late in the afternoon, about 1, 2, 3 o'clock, severe thunderstorms all the way down the line, and also around about Chicago. Airplanes going all over the place trying to get to O'Hare. Meanwhile, high pressure out in the middle of the country, not moving all that much. This low is going to try to sag into our sky here, but it won't do an awful lot because of that high that isn't going to move all that much. So we're just going to have to leave with that. Any clouds and rain will stay well to the north of us, but we may tap a little bit of this subtropical moisture once the trough comes a little bit closer, and that could get us a couple of showers of thunderstorms over the hills. Here's the lines of equal pressure. You see the thunderstorms in the Sierra already tomorrow afternoon, probably on the front range. Then clouds will start to increase a little bit on Sunday. Any real rain will stay well north of us, but we may tap that line into Monday. That could, with the help of the mountains, be some high-based cumulus clouds there, and maybe a thunderstorm or two, but the chance is pretty slight. Better up around the northern part of the state, so don't let it spoil your plans for the weekend. Ran the microcast out with clouds and wind here. We've got the usual sea breeze. You'll see some patchy fog. High clouds begin to filter in probably about Sunday around the in the morning already, and most of this is going to be thin cirrus, then it'll get thicker as it goes up, but it looks like any precip is going to stay way on the other side of the map for now, so we'll keep an eye on it. 60s and 70s, 80s down in the valley, so we'll cool off a little bit. We promise you a little bit of a cool down. Still, you get 90s, so that's not cool, that's warm. Morgan Hill, Gilroy, but by Sunday, Monday, I think you'll be back in the 80s. Same thing for the Salinas Valley, mid-70s to upper 80s between Salinas and King City, with the 90s staying south for one more day. And around the peninsula, just lovely. Mid to upper 60s after lows in the 50s, some 80s out in Carmel Valley and Big Sur, and also around Santa Cruz and Soquel. 78 at Watsonville for the fly-in, good weather there. 10 warmer in Scotts Valley and a couple left over 90s. So clear, local fog by the sea. We got a beautiful night. With the marine layer so low, it's not going to take long to clear it out. I think most beaches will see sunshine, and you're looking real good for a little breeze then. The next day, we'll add a couple of high clouds, but still pretty good there. Call it mostly sunny, and then we'll get to partly cloudy on Labor Day with some of that high-level moisture. Inland temperatures backing off a bit, 70s and 80s by Monday and Tuesday, and that chance of thunderstorms would be over the hills of southern Monterey and San Benito County. Pretty slight chance at that, but we'll put it in there just in case. And for the beaches, just leveling off, 60s and 70s, good place to park for a while, get you about normal. A little bit of night, morning fog and low clouds, nothing you haven't seen before, so get out and get a piece of the action. It's going to be a pretty one there.
Okay. Nice stuff.